In this video, I'm going to show you how to add existing data layers to a GIS project. This is done in pretty much the same way in all GIS software. I'm going to demonstrate how to do this in QGIS. I'm going to do it for a GIS project for an oak woodland study area set in central Scotland. There's three data layers already added to the GIS project. One that has an outline of the oak woodland for this particular study area. Another one, which provides a line data layer of nearby roads. And a third one that marks out the shoreline of a nearby lake. I'm now going to add two more data layers to this GIS project. One is another line data layer that represents a forestry track that runs through the middle of the oak woodland. And the second one is a point data layer of nest box locations that are used to study the breeding behavior of whole nesting birds in this study area. So to add these data layers, come up to Layer, Add Layer, and then select the type of data layer. In this case, Add Vector Data Layer, because I'm going to want to add a vector or feature data layer. This opens the Add Vector Layer window. We can click on Browse and select the data layers that we want. In this case, I'm wanting to select the forestry track data layer. Then I scroll down and find the second one, which is the nest box locations. I hold down the control button on my keyboard to select the second data layer. I now click Open, and then Open to add these data layers to the GIS project. Now, whenever you add a data layer to a GIS project, the first thing you should do is check what projection it uses. To do this, right-click on its name in the Table of Contents window, select Properties, and click on the General tab. And here under the Coordinate Reference System section, you can see what projection it uses. In this case, British National Grid, which is the same one that we're using for the GIS project, so that's okay. If the data layer was set to use a different projection coordinate system from the GIS project itself, we'd need to think about transforming it into the same projection as the GIS project before we could use it. We don't need to do that for this data layer. So we can now go onto the Style tab and change how it looks like. In this case, we want to make the line thicker, so we change the width to 1. We want to change the color to black. Once we've got it set the way we want it, we click OK. We can see that it's now changed in the map window. We do exactly the same again for the other data layer. So we come to Nestbox Locations, right click on it, Properties, go to the General tab, check that it's in the same projection coordinate system as the project, in this case British National Grid, which it is. Then we come to the Style tab, and we change the settings. In this case we want to make it slightly bigger, so we'll set the size to 3. We'll select the color to red. We now click OK. So now we've added the two data layers to our GIS project. We've checked the projection coordinate system and made sure it's compatible with our GIS project as a whole. Then we've changed how they're displayed, so they're displayed the way we want them to be displayed. And that's how you add existing data layers to a GIS project.